When working with Live, most of your work will occur in the main screen. Here's an overview of Live's user interface. In Live, you'll be working with two main views. The first view we're currently looking at is the session view. If I move the mouse to the top right-hand corner and click the icon, I can move between the session view and the other view, the arrangement view. A handy keyboard shortcut to remember is Tab, so you can easily move between these two different views. On the left-hand side of the session view screen is the browser. To the right-hand side of the browser, I find my tracks. Tracks can be either MIDI or audio tracks. All tracks in the session view are arranged vertically. Within each of these tracks, there is a routing matrix. For MIDI tracks, it's for routing MIDI, and for audio tracks, it is to route audio. To the right of my MIDI and audio tracks, I have my return tracks. And finally, my master track, where all the sound from MIDI, audio, and return tracks are summed together to one output. If a track contains a device or a clip, this can be seen in the detail view. The detail view can be collapsed should you need more space in Live's interface. At the bottom left, there's also a button that I can click that gives me access to the info view. This is a very useful window in the Live screen that helps you understand what parameters and devices are simply by mousing over them and reading what the window says. Let's have a look at the arrangement view. I'll use the keyboard shortcut Tab to access it this time. The first thing you may notice is that the detail view and the browser can both be accessed from the arrangement and the session view. And also you have access to the info view. The main difference you'll notice about the arrangement view is that it has a timeline, as opposed to the session view, which doesn't. The timeline runs along the lower part of Live's interface. In the arrangement view, all tracks are displayed horizontally. The routing and mixing sections are located to the right of the track color. Below audio and MIDI tracks are my return tracks and my master track. The top section of Live's screen stays the same for the arrangement view as well as for the session view, and this has several parts to it. Starting on the left, we have indicators for link, a button for tap tempo, tempo, time signature, a metronome, and launch quantization. To the right of that, we have a follow button, as well as position indication for the arrangement view and transport controls. Next to this, we have an overdub, automation arming, capture, as well as session record buttons. To the right of this, we also have location control for punch in and punch out and setting loops in the arrangement view. To the far right, we have a button to toggle a draw function, as well as a button to use a computer MIDI keyboard. Next to this, there's a button to toggle keyboard mapping and MIDI mapping, as well as a CPU monitor.